Right now, tonight's other headline, a republic if you can keep it. With his back against the wall, the president has re-embarked on an all-too-familiar campaign to undermine and cast doubt on American institutions. Because he didn't lose control of the House, America did. Almost as soon as the results were in, Trump questioned the validity of U.S. elections, unleashing a storm of tweets in the past 48 hours that, without any evidence, accused election officials in Florida and Arizona of fraud. On Wednesday, he turned his attention on the Mueller investigation, firing his own attorney general, Jeff Sessions, for failing to be his dutiful stooge at the Department of Justice. In his place, Trump bypassed the similarly principled number two, Rod Rosenstein, instead announcing the appointment of Matthew Whitaker as acting attorney general. Coincidentally, I'm sure Whitaker has been a vocal critic of the Mueller investigation, which he will now be charged with overseeing. Next in the path of Trump tornado, the president turned his wrath toward the press for daring to ask him questions. After a chaotic press conference on Wednesday, the White House pulled the press pass of CNN chief White House correspondent Jim Acosta. On Friday, when asked if Acosta's pass would be permanently revoked, Trump doubled down, saying more press passes could be pulled in the future.
I think Jim Acosta is a very unprofessional man. I think he does this with everybody. He gets paid to do that. You know, he gets paid to burst in. As far as I'm concerned, I haven't made that decision, but it could be others also.
He also fired away at a PBS reporter, calling her racist, and another CNN reporter calling her question stupid. And finally, though, check back in a few minutes, Trump renewed his attack on birthright citizenship, promising an executive order to end the practice. Because that's likely unconstitutional, though, the move is almost certain to tee up a battle in the Supreme Court. That's something the president readily acknowledges.
We will be signing it soon.
Is it a political stunt?
No. We're signing it. We're doing it. And it'll probably work its way up to the Supreme Court.
Yes, this is all fine. In a matter of 1 week, the president has attacked the rule of law and the Constitution on no less than three fronts. The independence of the Department of Justice, the First Amendment and freedom of the free press, and the 14th Amendment. Now, lest you say, but SE, you didn't care when Obama threatened the press. Oh, yeah, I did. Plenty of us were critical of the 44th president for seizing phone and email records of reporters from the AP and the New York Times and Fox News reporter James Rosen. Of course, other presidents before Trump were guilty of constitutional overreach. In 1937, FDR infamously attempted to pack the courts with friendly judges. There was the Box 13 scandal of 1948, when LBJ was accused of stuffing 202 additional ballots into a box, which miraculously swung the Texas Senate election in his favor at the last minute. And of course, there was Nixon's Saturday Night Massacre in 1973, where he fired both his attorney general and deputy attorney general when they refused to fire Archibald Cox, the special prosecutor charged with investigating the Watergate scandal. While history is replete with greedy and craven presidents who tried to expand executive power and undermine the Constitution, none has attacked the rule of law and the Constitution on so many fronts at the same time. And we haven't even gotten to the latest allegations of campaign finance violations by Trump. Here's the deal. As Americans, we have the distinct privilege of having inherited a Republican system of government, which conspicuously features systems of checks and balances and separations of power. Also enshrined in this republic, the rights of a free press, which in part is meant to ensure that those entrusted with the power this system affords them will be held accountable. Our system of democracy can be clunky, it can be slow, it sometimes can be arcane, but for the past 230 years, it's served us pretty well. The Founding Fathers, in their infinite wisdom, came up with a system to prevent the very kind of arbitrary, ego-driven, imperialist behavior that Trump finds so alluring, especially when he feels threatened. So the question is, how strong is our republic? We're about to find out.